I am going to start a lecture series of operational amplifier circuit. In that series, I will show you total 8 circuit example with operational amplifier, and this is the first example among them. See, we have to find the output voltage for this circuit. Here we have to calculate the output voltage from this terminal to the ground terminal. Before go into the circuit solution, let me show you the simulation of this circuit. See, I have set the circuit in the simulator. Here, let's say this will be our node B, this will be our inverting terminal, and this is our output terminal. See, our output terminal is extended up to this point. Now, let me show you the node voltages here. See, this node will have a voltage of 1.61 volt, and our output node will have a voltage of minus 4.5 volt. See, output has a voltage of 4.5, as minus terminal is in upward direction and plus terminal is in downward direction, so our output voltage will be minus 4.5 volt. See, this output terminal will be connected with the inverting terminal through this 8.4 kilo ohm resistor, so the circuit will be in negative feedback. Negative feedback makes the inverting and non-inverting terminal voltages equal. As this non-inverting terminal is directly grounded, so this non-inverting terminal will have a voltage of 0 volt, and that will make this inverting terminal voltage very close to 0. Here it is 45 microvolt. Ideally, we assume this is 0 volt. Okay, so the output voltage will be minus 4.5 volt, inverting terminal voltage will be 0 volt, and this node will have a voltage of 1.61 volt. Now let me show you the circuit analysis of this circuit. Here you will see the output terminal will be connected to the inverting terminal through a 8.4 kilo ohm resistor. When the output terminal is connected with the inverting terminal through a passive element, we can say that the circuit is in negative feedback. Let's say the non-inverting terminal voltage is Vp, and I assume the inverting terminal voltage equal to V2. When an operational amplifier is in negative feedback, non-inverting terminal voltage and inverting terminal voltages will be equal. Here, see, this non-inverting terminal is connected to ground, therefore our Vp will be equal to 0, which will make V2 equal to 0 volt. Now let's say I denote this terminal as terminal A and this terminal as terminal B. With respect to this A to ground terminal, I have a current source of 10 milliampere in parallel with a resistance of 1 kilo ohm, and with respect to this A and B terminal, I have a resistance of 9 kilo ohm in parallel with a 5 kilo ohm resistor. That means, as they are connected in parallel, I can reduce them to a single resistance, and I will calculate their equivalent resistance, R equivalent, by using this formula. When two resistances are connected in parallel, we calculate their equivalent resistance with this formula, R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So here I will take 5k into 9k divided by 5k plus 9k, which will give us a value of 3.2k. Now see, with respect to this terminal and this terminal, I have a current source in parallel with a resistor. If you are familiar with the source transformation theorem states that if I have a current source Is in parallel with a resistance Rs, and if they are connected with respect to, let's say here it is connected with the ground terminal and this end is connected with the A terminal, I can replace it with a voltage source of Vs in series with the resistance of Rs, and that will be connected with respect to A and ground terminal. This will be our Rs and this will be our Vs. As current will be supplying in this direction, so I will take the positive sign of the voltage source in upward direction and negative sign in downward direction, and Vs will be equal to Is into RS. What I want to say is that I will replace this current source and parallel resistance with a voltage source in series with a resistance of RS. Here RS is equal to 1 kilo ohm. Now what will be the value of VS? VS equal to IS, value of current source, 10 milliampere, 10 into 10 to the power minus 3 into 1 kilo. That means 1 into 10 to the power 3, which will be equal to 10 volt. So with respect to this A and ground terminal, I will replace the current source and parallel resistance with a voltage source of 10 volt and in series with a resistance of 1 kilo. And with respect to A and B terminal, I will replace these two resistors with a resistance of 3.2 kilo. So this was our A terminal, this was our B terminal. So our circuit will look like this. Now see, with respect to this terminal and B terminal, this 1 kilo ohm and this 3.2 kilo ohm resistances are connected in series. So I can reduce them to a 4.2 kilo ohm. So this will be our modified circuit structure. See, our output terminal is extended up to this terminal. So this node will have a voltage of VO. This is our inverting terminal and I have assumed the node voltage is V2, which is equal to 0 due to negative feedback, and this is our B terminal. Let's say I assume this node has a voltage of V1. Now I have to calculate VO or output voltage. It will be convenient for us if I apply nodal analysis in this circuit. After that I will calculate this output voltage. Now I will apply KCL at this node and this node. To apply KCL at the nodes, you have to familiar with the direction of the currents. As this is our 10 volt source, let's say a current I1 is entering from this direction. And a current I2 is leaving this node from this direction, and another current I3 is leaving this node in this direction. See, this I2 will be incoming at this node, so I will get I2 incoming at this node. And when an operational amplifier is in negative feedback, its inverting and non-inverting terminals current will be zero. So the current in this direction will be zero. Therefore this I2 will be returning through this 8.4 kilo ohm resistor. Let's say I denote that current with I4. Now you will see I have indicated the direction of currents at this node and this node. Now I will apply KCL at node B and at this inverting terminal. This I1 will be entering and this I2 and I3 will be leaving. So summation of incoming current will be equal to summation of outgoing currents, I2 plus I3. Now if I apply KCL at this terminal, I will get this I2 is entering and this I4 is leaving, and in this direction current is zero. So I will get I2 equal to I4. Now what will be the value of I2 and what will be the value of I4? See, current I2 is incoming from this terminal, so I have to assume this terminal is at higher potential and this terminal is at lower potential, because current always flows from high voltage towards low voltage. So I2 will be equal to, simple applications of Ohm's law, V1 minus V2 divided by 3 kilo ohm equal to, see, I4 is incoming from this terminal towards this terminal. That means I have to assume this terminal is at higher potential and this terminal is at lower potential. So simple application of Ohm's law, V2 minus V4 divided by 8.4 kilo ohm. Now if I put the value of V2 equal to 0, and see this is 3k and this is 8.4k, therefore I can eliminate 1000 from this denominator and this denominator. So I will get V1 divided by 3 equal to minus, see this is our VO divided by 8.4, from which I can write 8.4V1 equal to minus 3VO, that will be equal to 8.4V1 plus 3VO. Let's say I denote this equation with equation number 2. Okay, now let me deduce the equation number 1. See, I1 is incoming from this terminal to this terminal, and you will see this terminal will have a voltage of 10 volt, because we have a 10 volt source between this terminal to ground terminal, and this terminal will have a node voltage of V1, higher voltage minus lower voltage divided by resistance, which is the Ohm's law. 10 minus V1 divided by 4.2 kilo ohm equal to, see, I2 is the current that is flowing from this terminal to this terminal, so this terminal will be at higher potential, this terminal will be at lower potential. V1 minus V2 divided by 3 kilo ohm. See, I3 is flowing from this terminal to this terminal, so this terminal will be at higher potential and this terminal will be at a lower potential. V1 minus VO divided by 4.2 kilo ohm. And now see, I have kilo in the denominator, so I can eliminate 1000 from each of the terms, and if I take all of them in the left side, I will get 10 minus V1 divided by 4.2 minus V1 minus V2 divided by 3 minus V1 minus VO divided by 4.2. Now if I take the LCM of these three terms, I will get, so here I will get 30 minus 3V1 minus 4.2V1 plus 4.2V2 minus 3V1 plus 3VO divided by 12.6. 12.6 is the LCM of these three terms. Here, due to negative feedback, V2 will be equal to 0, and if I multiply this 12.6 with the right side, I will get 0. So from the numerator, I will get 30 minus 10.2V1 plus 3VO equal to 0, which will give us a value of minus 10.2V1 plus 3VO equal to minus 30. So see, I have equation number 1 and equation number 2. Now if I solve equation number 1 and equation 2, I will get V1 equal to 1.612 volt and V2 equal to minus 4.516 volt. See, the results are coherent with my simulation, so I can say that our output voltage will be minus 4.516 volt. Okay, that's it. Thank you.